Hey there, fellow scientists, it's Justin again. You caught us just in time. After all we've discovered about the structures of science, Mia and I were inspired to dive even deeper into how things are built. So we decided to embark on an engineering road trip around the state of Florida. Wait, would you like to come along with us? Yeah? Great, hop in. Today, we are starting our travels in Bradenton, Florida, and heading into St. Petersburg. Wait, why is my GPS telling me to drive right through this giant body of water? Oh, you're right, Mia. There must be a bridge. Oh, and there it is. And what a bridge. It's massive. I wonder why it's so high in the center. Wouldn't it have just been easier to build the bridge straight across the water? There must be a reason why they designed it this way, but who makes that decision? And why is this huge thing the design they landed on? Well, let's find out. By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to explain what civil engineers do and describe how their projects are important to our lives. Let's get into it. So, this enormous bridge is called the Sunshine Skyway, and the view from the top is amazing. Let's talk about the civil engineers who designed this gigantic bridge. But wait, what does a civil engineer do? Engineering is the branch of science that uses math and science to solve problems and create new things. Engineers design everything from airplanes to computers to skyscrapers. Civil means relating to regular people and their everyday concerns. So, what do you think a civil engineer does? Pause the video and record your thoughts in your guided notes. Civil engineering is the work of designing, building, and maintaining roads, bridges, tunnels, and so much more. These are all examples of infrastructure, or the basic structures communities use to live, work, and get around. Civil engineers also have to make sure our infrastructure is strong and long-lasting, even with tons of people using it. And all that traffic isn't the only thing civil engineers need to account for. There are tons of other environmental and natural factors that they have to plan for, especially here in Florida. What else do you think the engineers had to keep in mind when building this bridge? Pause the video and record your thoughts in your guided notes. Well, this particular bridge has to withstand Florida's high temperatures, hurricane force winds, and lightning strikes, all while helping people cross the water and allowing boats to go underneath. No big deal for a civil engineer though, right? So how did the engineers design this bridge? Is there anything else that this bridge does besides connect two pieces of land for transportation? They must have thought about different solutions to this particular problem. So why'd they design the Sunshine Skyway Bridge the way they did instead of using ideas like this or this? Well, civil engineers use a series of steps called the engineering design process to solve issues and create infrastructure. Let's put on our hard hats and learn how engineers built the Sunshine Skyway Bridge. We'll use the same steps that they did. Ask, research, design, test, improve, and build. Civil engineers first ask what the needs are. They noticed that people needed a way to drive from Bradenton to St. Petersburg in a way that was quick and safe. Building a bridge was an obvious solution. However, how would building a bridge impact boat traffic in the area? What would happen when a hurricane comes through? And would the benefits of building the bridge outweigh the costs or difficulties it might introduce? Next, they needed to research how other places have solved a problem like this. Well, some places have a ferry route to carry people and their cars across. But this can only carry so many cars and people at a time. And what about those big tractor trailers? Could a ferry even carry those? A bridge seemed like a good choice, but there are different kinds of bridges. Beam bridges are simple and straight, but would interfere with boat traffic. Arch bridges are curved and strong, but require more materials to build and need additional support structures. And suspension bridges are held up by strong cables, but they don't handle high winds very well. They needed to decide what kind of bridge would work best for their own unique situation. After researching the many different kinds of bridge designs, they decided that a cable-stayed bridge would be the best solution, because they're great for long distances and tall heights without needing extra pillars in the water that would get in the way of boat traffic. Then they needed to design a bridge to solve their problem, but that was easier said than done. It would have to be high enough for ships to travel under, strong enough to withstand hurricane winds, sturdy enough to transport lots of vehicles, and durable enough to withstand the relentless heat of Florida summers. To start, they drew sketches and blueprints of different bridge designs. During this step, they would also build small-scale versions of the bridge. Why do you think it's important to build small-scale models? Pause the video and record your thoughts in your guided notes. Creating a model helped them plan out how the construction would happen, step by step, what materials would be used, and what the estimated cost to build the design would be. Next, they needed to test the materials to make sure they were strong enough to withstand the conditions the bridge would be in. For example, strong winds, hurricanes, and heavy traffic. Based on the information the engineers learned from their tests, they needed to improve the design and materials. They go back and try different materials or designs if something didn't quite work out as planned with the model. They wanted to be sure the bridge would be as safe and strong as possible for all of the different weather conditions and traffic it'll handle. If the model didn't pass the tests, the engineers would go back to the design step and continue through the test and improve steps until they were confident that the bridge would hold up. Finally, the engineers needed to build the actual bridge by carefully following the design, blueprints, and model. They used the best materials and methods possible to ensure the bridge would be safe for vehicles and high enough for ships to pass underneath. Because of civil engineers and the engineering design process, the Sunshine Skyway Bridge was built, and people now have a safe and faster way to get around the Tampa Bay area. Civil engineers work on all sorts of infrastructure that impacts our lives. For example, roads help us travel and boost the economy by making the transportation of goods easier. Buildings like houses, skyscrapers, and everything in between give us places to live, work, and more. By making sure these kinds of different infrastructure are safe, functional, and comfortable, civil engineers impact all of our lives every day. Let's review everything we've learned today. Civil engineering is the work of designing, building, and maintaining infrastructure, and civil engineers are the people responsible for making sure our infrastructure is strong, safe, and useful. To learn more about how civil engineers build the things we use every day, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions that go with this lesson. Thanks for joining us today on the first stop of our engineering road trip, the breathtaking Sunshine Skyway Bridge. And remember, scientists, curiosity is the architect of discovery. See you next time! Hey, hey.